Hi, folks.
It's good to see Ed. It's good to be off the cuff. I'm Keith Murphy. This is Ed Wilson, and I love Christmas. I've said before, Thanksgiving's my favorite holiday as an adult. But as a kid, there was nothing like Christmas morning. Yeah. I mean, just the magic of Christmas, just the thought that Santa Claus had been there. And I have come to appreciate more as I get older how much work my parents put into Christmas. And I don't think I noticed as a kid, I wish I had at the time, that they really, I mean, we were of very humble means. I don't think they did for themselves. I think they just did for us. And they always made it a special Christmas. And I really appreciate it.
My mom was the oldest of eight, and I'm the oldest grandchild. So my mom's youngest brother is only 6 years older than I am. So I never felt like an only child. But their Christmases were ridiculous because my grandfather would invite people from the church that might need to stop by, or people that he knew that just didn't have a place to go. He would always invite them. So we would have literally five or six tables backed up all the way through their living room and into the Christmas tree. Like somebody was probably sitting with their back in the Christmas tree. And it was all food that my grandmother and of course, six daughters, there was a lot of food. Everybody prepared something and brought it. But those are some of the best memories. And I never got it. We never get it until you have your own kids, just like life. You don't get it until you go through it. Oh. But you get your kids in there, and then you think about how much work there is. Now, here's the brilliant thing that never happened in my family. And Angela brought this into my life. She said, my wife, she said, we're going to do Santa gifts that don't have to be wrapped. So these are the special gifts from Santa because, Santa brought them. He didn't wrap them. He just had them in the sleigh.
We made that same move.
When you were a kid or when you had
now.
Children?
Yeah. Now. Santa's presents weren't wrapped. Yeah. They were just in front of the fireplace.
It was fantastic.
That's how you knew they were from Santa, and that's how you knew I didn't have to wrap them or Jenny didn't have to wrap them. That's a good move.
Well, back in the 60s, Santa actually wrapped all of my presents and said, from Santa. So, you know, I knew it was from Santa, but I guess if they're unwrapped, you really know.
And did Santa have different wrapping paper?
I can't remember. Maybe.
So I don't know if I ever would have put any of that together, but when we were kids, the Santa's wrapping paper was noticeably different from the other presents. And then
that makes sense.
In our house, just the Santa just didn't wrap the presents for our kids for whatever reason. Like the bike would be sitting there, or the game would be sitting there, and game, that kind of thing. And then when the kids out of the house, and now when they come back at some point, and I'm so glad that Jenny did this. She came to the realization and some of the angst people had about trying to find the right present. And, as adults, trying to find something somebody doesn't have and that they actually want, because it always feels bad to spend money or to receive something somebody took time to go buy and spend money on, and it's not going to get used or it's not really wanted. That always makes you feel bad to be on the receiving end or the giving end of that. And it can be so hard to know what to get somebody. So we just kind of come as a family to that draw names, and one gift for that one person. You draw a name.
One with six boys.
And there's like a $30 cap on it.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
It kind of almost like an office, Secret Santa thing.
Yeah, yeah.
But I agree. And then when we get to be older, you don't want anything else in your house. I mean, seriously, going through my dad, and when I had to clear out his house, it really put me on that progressive move of, we are going to throw away every stinking thing in our house that we haven't used in a year. We're just going to get rid of it. And then when Christmas comes around, everybody wants to give you something, and that's where gift cards are perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Gift card or nothing. I mean, just stop by and say hi, but the kids want to get you something too, but gift cards, love it.
Gift cards I love too, and we have to... Jenny and I have a couple of gift card weekends a year where we only go to the movies with a gift card. We only go out to eat with a gift card, because if you're not careful, you can have those unused gift cards. I know in our newscast before, it's some crazy number, like 40% of gift cards go unused or something.
Yeah, I lose them. If I don't have that spot, we do have a spot in our house that has the gift cards, but then I forget about them when I'm out. It's a good idea to make a point to say, hey, this weekend we're going to do gift card weekend. I'm going to use that. I'm going to steal that.
Opening.
I'm going to call it my own, but I'm going to steal it.
Yeah, please do. It's all part of off the cuff. It's in our contracts if we had them. So Opening presents as a kid, as an adult, Christmas Eve or Christmas morning?
Always Christmas morning.
Same.
Yeah.
Same.
We do now on Christmas Eve, just special one, like, you know, for a couple of like little tiny gifts, things. Yeah, but the big ones are Christmas.
Yeah, we would always be allowed, as a kid, we could open one present on Christmas Eve. And that was a big deal. So you would identify someone in your extended family who was a good gift giver, like
right.
somebody who kind of understood what you wanted. Like for me, that was going to be Super Toe or Evil Knievel Stunt Motorcycle, something like that. And my grandfather was that guy that seemed to get me and get those good gifts, which was interesting because he wasn't a particularly warm grandfather,
and
or
he was
a big
picking up the gifts, or did Grandma do that?
It, you know, I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't know. It's too late to find out, too.
Yeah, big time.
Unfortunately, but he gave some good presents, and boy, you have some of those presents that you'll never forget. And another thing I'll never forget about Christmas is trying to assemble the presents for kids because I'm not real handy.
Yeah,
I like to think
I'm handy. I have tons of tools, but it's still...
You're better than I am at that kind of stuff. Like, I'm the guy that puts together the home console center, like the home mm-hmm. entertainment center, gets all the way to the end and realizes there's a shelf upside down.
Right. Or there's a bag of empty things, a bag full of things that should be empty. The bag should be, but then they look kind of important.
Oh.
Like, these are heavy-duty screws. When is this going to fall?
Put the bike together, and the kid's like, Dad, the tires don't move.
Yeah. Then it's the IKEA avalanche.
I love Christmas, though.
I do, too. It's my favorite thing. I start listening to Christmas music before Thanksgiving.
Oh, that's
our house is
some kind of violation.
Completely decorated right now.
Do you sing along as you're walking around? Because you have music that goes like into every room. Do you sing as you walk?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Of course.
I usually, you know, anymore, though, it bugs my wife just to hear me.
Oh.
So I give her the noise-canceling earbuds, and then I sing out loud.
That's a good gift.
Yeah,
it's a good gift.
Like Elf.
Well, Merry Christmas, or however you celebrate the holidays. And we appreciate you watching Off the Cuff.
Yeah.
We doing this in the new year?
Oh, gosh, yeah.
Okay.
And we hope that you're with
your
family,
still here.
Your friends, Friendsgiving, Friends Christmas, whatever, family. We hope you're having a great time.
Yes. Thanks for watching.